Hello, I'm Dr. Shashi Agrawal. I'm a consultant in obstetric and gynecology. I'm practicing currently as a consultant in Agrawal Healthcare, Bangalore, India. Peripartum management of hyperglycemia. Most important aspect of this is to avoid maternal hyperglycemia. This depends a lot on the control of sugars during pregnancy. In a lady whose sugars have been controlled well during pregnancy, the requirement of insulin is usually very minimal or not required. A woman with uncontrolled sugars during pregnancy may require higher doses of insulin. The fetal outcome also varies according to the maternal control of sugars during pregnancy. There is increased chance of fetal hypoglycemia and fetal acidemia if the maternal sugars are high during labor. So the key is to keep the blood sugars within 70 to 110 milligram per deciliter. Tight glycemic control is important to avoid adverse fetal and maternal outcome during labor. This can be achieved by keeping the woman, if the induction is planned, usually the woman is kept fasting overnight and early induction is planned. A continuous glucose infusion is started early in the daytime and regular blood tests are done, usually hourly. We try to maintain the blood sugars between 70 and 110. Any 50 units rise in the sugar levels should mandate an introduction of insulin, which is usually rapid acting insulin, of about 4 units for every 50 units rise. Throughout the labor, tight glycemic control is maintained, and during the labor, the metabolic requirements of the mother increase suddenly, so the insulins may come down. Caution is required in that period. After the delivery, in the postpartum period, the maternal insulin requirements are suddenly low because of the lactation, so the blood sugars should be titrated. The peripartum management of maternal hyperglycemia is also dependent on what type of diabetes the mother has, whether it's type 1 diabetes, in which the insulin requirements are little more because there is no inherent insulin in the lady. In type 2 diabetes, there is already some insulin in the body, so the requirements are generally lesser or sometimes not required at all.